Wait, listen to this. This sounds exactly like Frank Sinatra is singing Get Low by Lil Jon.
To the window, to the wall, until the sweat drops down my
back. No? How about Linkin Park singing the Pokemon song? Pokemon, gotta catch you. Or how about Johnny Cash singing Barbie Girl?
I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world.
These are all made using AI voice clones. Sinatra never sang Get Low, sorry. But the craziest part is that voice cloning is just the beginning of what's happening right now with AI music. AI is letting people create completely new songs as fake collaborations or generate lyrics or even melodies in seconds. That song that you're hearing in the background right now, that was made using AI. Just by typing in a few words. This stuff has gotten crazy fast, and people keep saying that AI is gonna be the death of music. Technology causes turning points in history. We've seen it happen countless times, and I think that we're in one right now for music. The stakes are high. If we get this wrong, we could jeopardize how human musicians make money and art. But if we get it right, we have an opportunity to leap ahead in how we as humans get to express ourselves. That might sound like hyperbole, but it's not. This is an extremely complex and controversial topic, and to really understand it, you have to understand how the music industry already works and how it might be changing. So, to do that, I reached out to two people right in the thick of it. The artist Grimes and the CEO of Spotify are gonna help me explain what's really going on in the fight over AI music.
AI generated music.
There will always be a problem with AI.
It's making the music industry very nervous.
We're drowning in music.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Don't come out.
Will this be something that artists actually embrace?
We really haven't figured out a way to compensate the creators.
How bad could this really be for artists in the music industry?
This whole messy fight over AI music really boils down to two big questions. One, what can AI music actually do for us? And two, when should artists get paid in a world where we have it? There are a lot of layers to AI music. In the style of Taylor Swift is different from cloning her voice, which is different from using her music to train an AI. And those nuances really matter for how the finished product gets treated. We're gonna get into all of it. But first, you might be wondering, why do we want this? Like, wouldn't having AI make music hurt human creativity and musicians? Not necessarily. I think if we get this right, AI can help us shrink what I'm gonna call the gap. The gap is the difference between the idea that's in your head, that's obviously perfect and amazing, versus what you can realistically create. Sometimes I'll try and make exactly what I imagined, but sometimes the truth is I'll shrink my idea because it's just what I can make with the tools that I have. Creativity isn't the same as technical skill. We sometimes confuse them because you've often needed one to show that you have the other. But lowering the amount of technical skill that you need to express your creativity is how we've gotten more great music throughout history.
A few hundred years ago, you needed to be a musical genius in order to create a composition, right? Someone like a Mozart or Beethoven, it was a huge cost to gather a whole orchestra to test ideas. So they had to test it by themselves. And I can only say that's a musical genius. So there weren't that many of those in the world that could do this.
I think we can agree we'd have less great music today if that were still the case.
Someone like an Avicii, who's now passed, in my opinion, he was a musical genius too. His tool was the computer.
I see AI as a new tool. A really, really powerful one. Artists can already use technology like ChatGPT to generate lyrics or Google's Music LM to create new melodies. In fact, you might be listening to that without knowing it.
I would be surprised if we didn't have already works of that kind on Spotify.
And musicians disagree about what to use AI for.
I don't think AI should write lyrics for you. I don't think AI should be able to just automatically generate music for you. I think that is probably not good for the human mind.
I was very interested to hear Grimes say that because she's one of the first artists to come out in favor of another controversial use of AI, voice cloning.
If you press record and just sang like Old MacDonald or something.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
I was singing because Grimes was teaching me how to use a tool that she recently released called Elf Tech, which lets anyone change their voice into hers.
And on that farm he had a pig, E-I-E-I-O.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a pig, E-I-E-I-O.
It just transformed my singing into yours. If you go to Spotify right now and type in Grimes, two verified artists come up. That's Human Grimes. And that's the collaborator for anyone else who uses her voice on Spotify.
And like the really good ones, we're gonna go back and give them a full featuring Grimes. And then when I release my album, I'm also gonna release a competitive AI album.
So like releasing like a Grimes album and a Grimes AI made by others album at the same time.
Yes, and which one performs better?
Grimes is excited about this, but a lot of other artists are extremely not okay with people using their voice this way.
People should have consent. If you want copyright and you don't want people to use your name and likeness and your stuff, that's cool. But like I personally enjoy it.
All right, now it's gonna get even more controversial. When should artists get paid in a world with AI music?
Major concern in the music industry.
It violates copyright law.
Could lead to major legal battles.
Who gets paid?
The thing to know here is that the music industry already has rules for this. The question now is whether AI can fit into that system, or if something's gotta change. For decades, whether an artist gets paid or not depends on how the industry defines what is inspiration versus what is copying. This box, getting inspired by someone and not paying them, is most music.
I was inspired by a lot of great singers.
There's so much Beatles inspiration in there.
My greatest influence was Whitney.
George Michael, Whitney.
This box, directly copying someone and paying them for it, is also totally fine. Doja Cat did that in that new song of hers that goes, Wakampa.
Bitch, I said what I said. I'd rather be famous instead.
Now here's the original. This is just sampling. Doja Cat needs to pay whoever owns the original composition of the song and the original recording. Or a musician might re-record a line or a melody from someone else's song and use it in their new one. I'll use Ariana Grande as an example.
Breakfast at Tiffany's and bottles of bubbles.
Na 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 na.
Does that sound familiar? Na 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 na. I'm gonna stop singing now.
These are a few of my favorite themes.
That's interpolation. Ariana Grande needs to pay the original composer of the song, but she's not using the original recording, so she doesn't need to pay for that. Or an artist could re-record an entire song. That's just covering. Again, gotta pay the owner of the original composition. What Grimes is doing fits in here too, actually. People are making new songs and new recordings, but they are using her voice and likeness, so they've agreed that they should pay her. In all of these cases, though, some original owner is getting paid. It doesn't matter how you made the track, if you use AI to do any of these things, you still gotta pay. And if you try not to, yikes.
I'm gonna sue you! I'll see you in court!
Copying an artist and not paying them? That's what our entire existing copyright system is built for. Copyright protects the original song recording, the master, and separately, the composition of the original song itself. Like a lot of the law, though, it's less a list of rules and more a list of lawsuits. In 2015, for example, Pharrell Williams and Robin Thicke had to pay $5 million after losing a lawsuit claiming that their song, Blurred Lines, copied the composition of Marvin Gaye's Gotta Give It Up. Versus, Ed Sheeran recently won a lawsuit over this chord progression in his song, Thinking Out Loud.
Darling, I will be loving you.
Which the heirs of Ed Townsend claimed was copied from a song that he co-wrote, Let's Get It On.
Let's get it on.
Sometimes it's just messy. Like Olivia Rodrigo retroactively gave Taylor Swift songwriting credits on some of her songs, and therefore a lot of money in royalties, because other people accused her songs of being too similar. But what about an artist's vibe, like in the style of Taylor Swift? Or even making a song that sounds like two artists collaborating, but it's not their composition and it's also not their original recording. This is where all hell breaks loose. You can't impersonate someone, but you can parody them. You can't copy specific producer tags, like another one.
Another one. Another one. Another one. Another one.
But you can copy phrases that other people have used, even if they're super famous, like Jason Derulo.
Jason Derulo!
You can't use another song's melody, but you can use popular chord progressions. The copyright system is just incredibly complicated. And it's a fight every time people disagree. That's true whether it's made with AI or not. But there is a question that's specific to AI, which is, should artists get paid if an AI trains on their music? Is that inspiration or is that copying? The AI tools that we're talking about require thousands of songs in order to learn. These training datasets are just enormous, and the companies that use them aren't always exactly forthcoming about what they're using. But it's important to know that these AI tools aren't really sampling or interpolating or covering. They're not taking pieces of the music in their datasets and collaging them. They're analyzing patterns and creating entirely new works based on them. Inspiration or copying. You might have noticed that right now, the way that the industry decides is based entirely on the output, not the input. In theory, you could download someone else's entire song if you then changed it enough so that it wasn't similar in the end. So artists get paid if the end result sounds enough like them, whether their music was used to make it or not. You could change that, but it would mean filling a box that so far has never been filled, paying artists for what the industry calls inspiration. But it might change. There are several ongoing lawsuits worth keeping an eye on across different art forms. I asked Daniel how he thinks about this.
If I'm an artist on Spotify, does it matter what tools I use, depending on like how they're trained and all of that?
We wouldn't know what tools you're using in creating your music. We get them as audio files at the end of it, and we wouldn't know how that was generated. Every musician learned on the back of every other musician in the past. So the fact whether it's trained on or not, I respect that that is an ongoing debate, but I think the more important one is the output of that training. We want it to be really new IP, not something that's drafting off someone else's name and likeness. When it gets too close, where it's confusingly similar, what it is, that's kind of where I draw the line.
But if AI actually begins to make music more autonomously, then it becomes less a tool for artists and more an artist?
You may have totally autonomous AI agents that are creators on every platform that just generate not one song, 100 songs, or 1,000 songs, but like a million, 10 million, 100 million, a billion songs, and just test their way into what may work. And that's the one I feel is harder to figure out because it's not clear to me who owns the IP in that regard or even how to think about it, because is it a creator? Is it not a creator? You know, the AI, we wouldn't treat as a creator, but the person behind the AI, we would, right?
Like, this is where I start to get existential. If I listen to a piece of music and I like it, if it makes me dance or sing or cry, do I care if an AI made it? But on the other hand, I really believe that music is human expression. It is awe and love and joy and fear and jealousy, all woven into waves in the air. I really think it's one of the best ways that we have to communicate between our lonely little brains what it's like to be alive. If AI is a tool to help us do more of that, awesome. There's obviously a lot that we need to do to figure out how to make sure that musicians are compensated fairly. But I think that AI can be a tool to help us form more of those connections.
There's a lot of people that may not have believed that they had a musical talent that all of a sudden would realize that they actually do. And that's why I'm so excited about this technology at the end of the day.
I look around at the incredible amount of human expression that we communicate through music. And I think to myself, oh my God, how much more of that is out there, locked inside people's minds? And what would happen if we set it free? Thor wanted to say hi. This was a really hard episode to write. It was really fascinating, but really complicated, and there's still so much that we're figuring out about this topic. But I just wanted to say thank you, because when you subscribe to our show, you're giving us the ability to go interview people like the CEO of Spotify and Grimes, and some of the episodes that we have coming up, I can't tell you about yet, but they're gonna be amazing. And I feel really, really grateful that you're here supporting this show. So thank you.